reading your comments. Let's go. What I heard about Josh and saw what he posted, I was honestly disgusted. He was my favorite member, and just seeing that I don't support him anymore. Also, when the post about the Farrah brothers leaving got released, it always felt like Zach got dragged into the argument and never really got his say when it was Josh saying everything and not really letting Zach get his own word in. True that. Well, MGK's a rocker now, covering Paramore songs, so I guess Jeremy thought, hey, that gives me an idea. Here's the difference between Jeremy Davis and MGK. One was in Paramore, the other one wasn't, and again, I'm not saying that MGK can't cover Paramore, but I think what makes it good is that people will realize how bad MGK's Misery Business cover is, that they'll just go and listen to actual Paramore to stop the bleeding of their ears. LOL, why can't Ariana sing about fucking? It's not that I said she couldn't sing about fucking, it's just why does there have to be a whole album about her wanting to fuck? It just seems a little too much to me. Like, yeah, sprinkle some songs in there, but we don't want a whole album about how horny you are and how much you just want a man to just rail you. Why do you hail Satan? So this is from my last reading your comments video, just for the context. I put reading your comments number 666 Hail Satan, and obviously, I think everybody else got that it was just a joke. Dylan, Dallin. Okay, I still don't know how to say Dallin Weeks. I think it's Dallin. I don't know. I think it is, but, you know, people have been telling me otherwise. It's another one, like, where I said Neil Peart, and somebody's like, well, no, it's not correct. And I'm like, no, I'm for sure that's correct, but other people have said it differently before. This is that case where I've heard Dylan, I've heard Dallin, and I just still don't know, to the point where I'm just at waiting for Dallin Weeks to say his name, because, Jesus Christ, I need this debunked now. Proofy posted it, LMAO. I could go on plebit sites and write celebrity stories like I lived through them too. Well, considering that this came from Titanic Sinclair's Reddit page, it's most likely him, unless his Reddit page got hacked, but we all know the tangents he's known to go on. But again, I didn't want to send hate that video, so I didn't necessarily give out his Reddit because that would just be a shit thing for me to do. Although, actually, I think I did. Still don't send hate to him. It's just not the right thing to do. I just wanted to kind of react to what he was saying in this case, so don't send hate. Don't do that. I didn't love this album, but I've never really understood too many features as a critique. The Gorillaz do this a lot. I like the fact that the Gorillaz don't necessarily have a set sound that they have, but I feel like on their albums they rely too much on the features to take over, like, the memorable parts in this case. And I think it just brings the band down as a whole, because I was like, you know, the Now, we at least got to see them a little bit more as a band because it wasn't so many features. But, you know, from Humans to this past record, Song Machine 1, and I get, too, that the preference of Song Machine is to have somebody else on and help you out with these songs to kind of come up with something different on the spot. But in the end, I just can't get a grip on the Gorillaz because every single song I pretty much heard from them has some sort of feature in a way, and it just never gives me an opportunity to really comprehend the band or what they're made of. So that's why they've always been 50-50 for me. And that whole album review wasn't necessarily me going, oh, too many features is why I brought it down. I told you why it was brought down. I said they still have this thing where they may bring on too many features, and that's the case because there is such thing as too many features. If you have an album like that, I think 5 would be the maximum, but to have one on every single track, sometimes more than one, just seems a little bit grab baggy to me. I don't know. I think I'm in the minority here. A lot of people might hate me for saying that, but the Gorillaz are grab baggy because of the features that they put on their records. Basically like rap, when they try to just get anybody they can on the record just for shits and giggles. That's just what the Gorillaz seem like to me at this point. Calling Corey Taylor fans dummies. Brave move. I mean, I'm a Corey Taylor fan too. I'm a Slipknot fan and a Stone Sour fan. And I will say it once, and I will say it again. If you thought Corey Taylor's solo album was going to sound anything like Slipknot or Stone Sour or be heavy in any of the slightest, you're a dummy. You're stupid. Because there was no way that was going to happen. Why would he make a solo record that would sound the same as his two bands he's currently in? That would just be boring because we've heard it before. I commend him for doing this. And anybody saying, oh, the record didn't sound like this and this is your reason for hating it and not giving out other specific reasons, then you're a dummy. Slam on me now. For me, cringe is not the word, but rather cute or adorable, if you will. Poppy has moved on a lot since she was 17, 18 years old, and now tours the world and directs videos and has a huge fan base. I find Poppy to be one of today's more interesting artists, and I always look forward to more from her, and even from her former partner, Poppy Rocks. I do agree, I do enjoy her, and I do think that she was one of the more, really, one of the first attention grabbers on, like, YouTube that really got us going, huh, and then it turned into this whole music career thing. As for the whole thing of me putting "it's just as cringe as you would think" in that last Poppy reaction video I did, I'm not calling it cringe per se, it's just more of an attention grabber. I don't really know what to call it because I do understand that in that video she is 17, 18 years old. When I was 17, 18 years old and making YouTube videos, which was like my start like 4 or 5 years ago, they were definitely ones I look back on and go, yeah, those were bad. And I even said in the video, I can see why she maybe deleted a lot of these older videos like this because it just, you know, you look back at it now and you go, wow, she went from that to that. It's pretty cool to just see where you came from in this sense too, and that's one of the reasons why I reacted to it, because we know she can do better, she's done way better, but in this case, you just get to see how much she's grown, and me calling it cringe was just kind of like, yeah, well, back then, I think that's the way YouTube was, you know, even though it was getting better with its content and whatever, this is still how YouTubers did things, but if someone were to make a YouTube video like that now, it would be seen as the cringiest thing on the internet. Slam on me now! Another dislike, sorry. Like, that hurts my fucking feelings. Slam on me now. So yeah, that is it, guys. You guys just keep commenting, and some of it's nice, other times it's not great. I mean, that Gorillaz review was, I did get a lot of nice comments saying that they disagreed with me, but then I got some comments that were like, you know, calling me a dumbass and that I didn't know what I was talking about for just giving my opinion, and it's like, well, I mean, you clicked on the video to hear my opinion, not your opinion, so I'm sorry to say that, you know, I don't care. That's basically it for me. Just stay safe out there, and until then, guys, I will catch you all in the next one.